What do you think when you hear the word innovation? And then you add Call of Duty to that. COD is a franchise that has changed a lot over the years. In fact, many of these changes ended up setting industry standards. But what changes in COD history have made the biggest impact, not only on the series itself, but the FPS genre as a whole? Well, today we're going to go over those, the biggest innovations in COD history. And we're going to kick things off with Specialist. Now, before you dislike the video, hang on. Let me say that I know a lot of people really didn't like the Specialists. They were introduced in Black Ops 3, then brought back in Infinite Warfare and BO4. And each game interpreted the idea in different ways. Now, in Black Ops 3, each Specialist had a big special ability, charge up throughout the match. Infinite Warfare, a few passive abilities you could choose from, which made the gameplay a little bit deeper. But then in Black Ops 4, each Specialist had their own special ability, as well as a unique piece of equipment that only they could use. Every game had a different level of emphasis on the Specialists. While a lot of people didn't like them, they were still a rather big innovation. Adding special abilities to a game like COD had a big impact on things, and you can see that influence in other multiplayer games, Destiny 2, Overwatch, Apex Legends. So while you may not have enjoyed the Specialists, they were definitely a pretty big innovation, and they shook up the formula. Guys, do me a favor. If you enjoy the content, make sure you're following the page. Make sure you ring that little bell. Turn the notifications on. Whatever you have to do to be notified when a new video goes live. At number 9, and my favorite of all time, gold camo in Black Ops 1. Now, Black Ops 1 wasn't the first COD game to have gold camo. I know that. But it was the first one that had the gold camo grind. In COD 4, there were a handful of guns with gold camo. But in Black Ops 1, every primary weapon in the game could have gold camo unlocked, and it was a huge grind. But you know what? People loved that grind. It was super satisfying to work your butt off and then finally hit the button to unlock gold camo for that gun. And I've said it before. I said it just a minute ago. Black Ops 1 had the best gold camo ever. Now, after Black Ops 1, gold camo was an expected feature of every COD game, and the camo grind became a staple of the series. But you know what else the Black Ops series innovated? More camos. Diamond camo. Black Ops 2. After BO1 gave us gold, Black Ops 2 changed things even further. Diamond. When Black Ops 2 first came out, nobody knew diamond camo was there. We weren't expecting this giant camo grind, but we ended up getting the first mastery camo in COD history. Diamond camo looked amazing in BO2, and it completely changed the way we looked at COD moving forward. Now, every new COD game is expected to have these crazy mastery camos, and it all started because Black Ops 2 innovated it back in 2012. Let's stick with Black Ops 2. The Pick 10. I mean, it's not easy to come up with ways to shake up the formula without making people upset. It seems like every time a COD game tries to change a central mechanic, it ends poorly. But the Pick 10 system in Black Ops 2 was the exact opposite. People loved it. When developing Black Ops 2, Treyarch devs said they got the idea by playing card and board games, and they felt this was a much better way to increase customization without screwing with Call of Duty's core formula too much. The Pick 10 system opened up a ton of new possibilities, perks, attachments, equipment, the list goes on. It was super fun. The Pick 10 system became a staple of the series, and a lot of people are still asking every single year for its return. At number 6 today, zombies. Yep, zombies in World at War. This was an innovation I don't think anybody expected to be so popular, not even Treyarch. During development of World at War, a small team within Treyarch designed a zombie survival game, or a mode, actually. They used the game's assets, and it was a joke. They threw it in World at War as a little surprise bonus mode, but little did they know, it would completely change the COD franchise. Zombies mode caught on big time and quickly became an expected feature. The gameplay was very similar to the popular Horde mode at the time from Gears of War, but there were some unique elements like the doors, the perks, the power-ups, stuff like that. As the COD series progressed, so does zombies mode. And it never would have started if that little team within Treyarch had a bright idea to make a zombie survival mode out of the game's assets as a bonus. At number 5 today, the Gunsmith in Modern Warfare 2019. I said a couple entries ago, it would be very difficult to find a way to shake up the COD formula without ruining it. Well, Infinity Ward pulled it off in Modern Warfare, the Gunsmith. New system gave you more gun customization than ever before, and the community loved it. It added a ton of extra depth in the gameplay without having to mess with the core design. That's the key. Every gun in the game, it could now be customized to a ridiculous degree, fine-tuning it just about any playstyle you want. The Gunsmith returned in Black Ops Cold War, and if you ask me, I don't think this one's going anywhere. I think it's a staple now. It would be weird to go from the Gunsmith back to the Black Ops 2 attachment system, although, a lot of people want to return to the simpler Pick 10 system, so I guess we're going to have to wait and see what happens. Next up, perks. Perks in COD 4. Back in the mid-2000s, military shooters were simple. You picked your team, you picked your soldier class, and it was basically all you got to choose. All that changed in 2007 was COD 4 and everything. Infinity Ward wanted to keep the core game rather simple, but still wanted to complement different play styles. This led to the idea of perks. Every player got 3 perks to put on their character, which would help you fine-tune your play style to fit a certain role. You could use perks to make you stronger, but it would give up stealth. You could make yourself a ninja at the cost of lower damage. You could make yourself a tech expert with things like Bomb Squad and Saboteur. Perks completely changed Call of Duty, and it heavily influenced the entire FPS genre as a whole. Here's another one. COD 4 was just on it. Killstreaks. I mean, that literally changed the FPS genre everywhere, forever. During COD 4's development, Infinity Ward wanted a game that played quickly and encouraged engagement, which gave them an idea. Let's reward good players with instant rewards to alter the battlefield. Very simple. 3 kills a UAV, 5 kills an airstrike, 7 kills an AI-controlled helicopter. The streaks were very simple back then, but they had a giant impact on the gameplay. Now, the killstreaks encouraged constant engagement, and they made the worst players want to get better so they could contribute to the team. Killstreaks in COD 4 changed everything. But you know what else changed everything? I'm about to tell you. Score streaks. Black Ops 2 again. Now, killstreaks were a huge hit in COD 4, and they remained a staple of the series for years. But there were a lot of criticisms that the system rewarded good players while punishing the worst ones. The rich got richer and the poor got poorer. So in response to this, Treyarch wanted to make the system a little more helpful to the little guy, as well as encourage objective play as opposed to just getting kills. Yeah, they came up with the score streak system, which was introduced in Black Ops 2. It fixed just about every problem people had with the kill streak system. You can now earn a ton of points by playing the OBJ, and you also got points for landing assists, playing support roles, and killing people. Score streaks finally made playing the objective a good thing, and this completely changed COD. I mean, it returned in Advanced Warfare, BO3, Infinite Warfare, World War II, and Black Ops 4 before being reverted back to Modern Warfare 2019, which to me, it was a big mistake. Score streaks keep the objective players happy while still rewarding the slayers. It's the perfect balance in the perfect system. And at number one today, custom killstreaks, Modern Warfare 2. Now, COD 4 introduced killstreaks and World at War kept them in place, but MW2 expanded upon them and changed COD forever. Modern Warfare 2 was a game meant to blow everything up to an insane degree. Literally, more guns, more attachments, more equipment, more perks, and of course, more killstreaks. The ability to customize your killstreaks was awesome, and some of the most expensive streaks, they were devastating. The chopper gunner, the AC-130, the Harrier strike, the stealth bomber, and the now legendary tactical nuke. Come on, 25 kills. Killstreaks may have changed the FPS genre, but Modern Warfare 2's custom killstreaks changed things even more. To this day, custom killstreaks are an absolute necessary feature. They are. No new COD game, I'm calling it, will ever launch without them. And it all stemmed from Modern Warfare 2. And there you have it, my friends. Those are some crazy big innovations, game-changing innovations, genre-changing innovations throughout COD history. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you soon.